Hi, my name is Scott Hebbard, and this webinar will discuss requirements management in Enterprise Architect 13. Many requirements start life as a handwritten diagram, a post-it note, email, or office document. Enterprise Architect can help bring all of these elements together under a unified platform, offering collaboration, traceability, change management, and impact analysis. A shuttle launch example has been used to illustrate how to store, discuss, and manage requirements in Enterprise Architect 13, allowing all stakeholders to contribute to the development of a robust set of requirements. Enterprise Architect 13 provides powerful tools for requirements management and activities associated with discovering, evaluating, analyzing, and reporting on your project requirements. The Specification Manager helps you to rapidly build your specification using a familiar text-based editor. A requirements diagram helps convey information about your requirements to key stakeholders. We examine the structure of a requirement and see how to analyze information presented in a requirements diagram to help you make better decisions. We apply various visualization techniques, including diagram filters and diagram legends, to help convey information about requirements within our model. Traceability helps us to understand the impact that change may have on our model. We'll also look at the traceability window and the innovative time-aware modeling capability available in Enterprise Architect 13. At the conclusion of the webinar, you should have a better understanding of some of the requirements management tools available in Enterprise Architect. Let's start by taking a closer look at the Specification Manager. For those of you unfamiliar with the ribbon interface, simply type a word to find the command or tool you are looking for, in this case, specification. All of the tools you need are now at your fingertips. Once we open the specification view, we can navigate to the package we need to edit or review. Many of you will be comfortable with writing specifications in Word documents or even spreadsheets, but you've probably also felt the pain of reduced traceability involved with a document-centric approach. This is where the Specification Manager in Enterprise Architect can help. It gives you the familiar document editing environment, while also making it easy to connect your project requirements to downstream design and implementation models. As you can see, it's very easy to update requirement names, edit notes, address spelling mistakes, and create new glossary terms. For example, I'm defining the term freezing to ensure that it is not confused with the term absolute zero and uses a metric value. Without clarity, these requirements become ambiguous, which can lead to software problems. Use a field chooser to add additional information about requirements such as a version number or priority. The Specification Manager makes a process of reviewing, proofreading, and editing requirements quite simple. Now let's take a look at a requirements diagram. The package diagram on screen helps to sort our requirements into logical containers such as functional and non-functional requirements and a use case model. Our functional requirements are further broken up into console, safety, and launchpad management. The requirements diagram on screen is used to convey visual information about the status of each requirement, while the connectors describe the relationships that exist between the various model elements. Each requirement includes a name for identification, a detailed description, and can link to glossary terms to ensure the requirements definition is well understood by all stakeholders. The main tab contains rich metadata that describes properties such as type, status, author, difficulty, version, and phase. Any change to the status of a requirement will result in that element color changing on the diagram accordingly. This visual information allows us to glance at a diagram and understand why requirements are important and how they are connected to other model elements. You also have the ability to create your own custom types to better suit the needs of your project. For example, there are many requirements in our shuttle launch system that need to be approved by the launch director. So I'm going to create a new custom status called Approved by Launch Director. Simply provide a status, description, and color for your new type and save the results. We can now use the status Approved by Launch Director throughout our project. The requirements diagram now reflects the custom status that we've just created. Diagram legends can be used to overlay supplementary visual information on a diagram. For example, we can easily identify the priority of all requirements shown on screen. A different color has been assigned to represent high, medium, and low priorities. Select the Apply Auto Color checkbox to enable the diagram legend and click OK. You can customize the options to suit your individual needs, including changing the colors of connectors. The diagram legend makes it easy to see that there are 4 high priority requirements that need attention, 2 low priority requirements, and 3 medium priority requirements. Enterprise Architect provides a number of tools that make it easy to review requirement properties. Diagram filters are available from the Layout ribbon in Enterprise Architect 13. They allow you to quickly and easily modify the appearance of a diagram. For example, we can display all requirements that were authored by Scott. Looking at the properties for Requirement 27, it has been written by Scott. We can quickly modify the filter to identify which elements have been written by Tom. It is also possible to filter on properties such as type, status, alias, difficulty, version, and even custom tagged values. Many business analysts often need custom attributes or properties that meet the needs of a specific project. In Enterprise Architect, these custom attributes are provided by tagged values. Tagged values are additional properties that can be assigned to UML elements and connectors. On screen, I've created a number of filters that evaluate tagged values. For example, the requirement Manage User Accounts has a tagged value called Shown in Webinar, which is set to true. When I enable the filter, Manage User Accounts is highlighted on screen. I can also quickly identify which requirements have been approved or denied by the launch director. Enterprise Architect 13 introduces diagram filter groups and also offers logical operator for filtering groups. This allows me to quickly determine which requirements have been written by Scott, which requirements have been written by Tom. We can also select the group of filters to see which requirements have been written by Tom or Scott. Obviously, when we change a logical operator, the filter produces a different result. Filtering on tagged values provides enormous flexibility and can be applied to costs, regulations, or even your own custom settings. I want to briefly show you how to create a tagged value filter based on a set milestone. So I'm going to create a filter called Check Milestone. The active filter set will be on tag value. The property is going to be equal to milestone, while the value is going to be equal to completed on time. Now if I enable Check Milestone filter, it highlights a requirement that has been completed on time. Charts are another tool we can use to analyze the aggregate results from our requirements model. On screen, we have a simple chart that outlines how many requirements have been written by staff. I'm going to update the chart to look at the console operation package and include any child packages that may exist. This chart is dynamically generated. It shows selected properties of the model elements. If I happen to update my model or a given diagram, I can refresh a chart and I'll be able to automatically see those changes reflected in the chart results, which in this case will see the number of elements authored by Scott Hebbard increase by 1. The standard chart element is available from the toolbox. Simply drag the chart element onto the diagram, select your desired chart type, and configure the data source accordingly. Enterprise Architect can create a number of different charts, including pie charts, bar charts, and line graphs. Another tool that can help improve requirements design is a checklist. The requirements checklist is a convenient element that can track if a requirement complies with a set of predefined measures, including whether a requirement is atomic, cohesive, traceable, and verifiable. You can add additional items such as peer-reviewed and specify whether it's grade or use the strikeout feature. When working with requirements, it is sometimes very useful to refer to a common set of best practices and qualities that help define the nature of a well-formed specification. The requirement checklist element is designed to meet this need. In this webinar, we've looked at how the Specification Manager can edit and review requirements. We've shown how the requirements diagram helps convey rich information about the status and custom attributes to key stakeholders. We looked at how diagram filters and diagram legends can be applied to learn more about our requirements. Now I'd like to take a look at traceability and discuss a typical scenario that might be familiar to many BAs. Looking at the discussion section of Enterprise Architect, I can see that someone on the team has identified that a requirement is incorrect. You can see that this requirement is wrong because the wind speed is not calculated at the launch and landing site. The launch can't be aborted safely if the shuttle can't land. So a developer said they'll fix it. The time-aware modeling feature allows analysts to create incremental versions of their models, providing easy access to tools that facilitate the migration of elements through multiple versions. The first step is to clone a structure as a new version. When using time-aware modeling, a modeler will typically want to create a new version of a group of elements that are collected together in one or more packages. So I'm going to clone my Safety Operation Management package. I shall rename the heading and then filter the diagram to only show version 2 elements. This makes it very easy to compare as-is and 2B models. I shall now clone an element as version 2.0 and make the appropriate changes. I'm going to change the name of the requirement, edit the author, and make a few other minor changes. I can now repeat the process and clone version 3 of the Safety Operations Requirements package. Enterprise Architect now makes it easy to see the evolution of a model over different versions and create new versions of model elements automatically without altering the underlying structure of the as-is model. This gives an analyst greater control over the evolution and traceability of your overall model. Once again, I plan on changing the heading and then cloning a new element, making changes to the crosswind speeds at both the launch and landing site. I can also edit the notes of the requirement and change a priority. This is an example where an element discussion has led to a series of requirement changes to improve safety. Once the shuttle launches to abort the mission, it must be able to land safely, and this is not possible if wind speeds are too high at the landing site. The diagram now clearly indicates which elements have been updated to version 3. and you can easily do a side-by-side comparison to see how a diagram has evolved from one generation to the next. Requirement number 27 has now changed over all three versions of our model. But how can you trace a particular requirement that has changed over time? You can use the Insert Related Elements tool to easily build your own traceability diagram and show the evolution of a requirement over time. Simply set the depth level. Now for this example, I'm interested in traces. Remember to press the Refresh button to see an up-to-date list of items. Select the items that you want to appear on your diagram and click OK to automatically generate your traceability diagram. Traceability diagrams can be used to conduct an impact analysis. It is also possible to bring up the relationships window. If you want a quick overview of the relationships of one or more elements in your model, you can obtain this from the relationships window. This window lists all of the relationships of the elements currently selected in the diagram, or from the project browser showing the relationship type, the direction of the relationship, any stereotype on the relationship, the names of the source and target elements in the relationship, and characteristics of the source and target elements, such as type, stereotype, role, and cardinality. So we've used Enterprise Architect to automatically generate a traceability diagram that shows how a requirement has evolved over time. Time-aware models offer enormous potential to modelers, and we look forward to hearing feedback about how you choose to use them in your projects. For more information about Requirements Management or Enterprise Architect 13, visit the Sparx Systems website on www.sparxsystems.com.